Networks have developed far beyond what was imagined only 10 years ago. Today, it's not just data being carried between sites. It's also telephone communication, video streams, medical images, educational materials, and many other forms of communication. These different types of multimedia all require different levels of service to support the communication. Some need more bandwidth, some need less delay, and others need to prevent loss of data. ATM is designed to meet all these communication needs. Additionally, before ATM, communication was separated. Data on one network, voice on another, and video on still another. This required three different networks to support the three different types of communication. ATM is designed to meet all these communication needs as well. Next are quality of service needs. Quality of service, or simply QoS, is important not just in relation to the bandwidth needs of applications, but for different users as well. Obviously, managers should be guaranteed that their data is given priority on the network and not delayed. Also, time of day issues should be applied to the quality of service given to different types of communication traffic. Again, ATM is designed to meet all these communication needs, too. And, finally, look at the way networks are designed today. Some protocols are used in the LAN and others in the WAN. Different levels of bandwidth are also dependent on which protocol you're running. Why can't we have a single protocol designed to work in the LAN, the MAN, and the WAN, as well as offer the amount of bandwidth required? Well, I'll bet you're getting the point by now. ATM is designed to meet these communication needs, too. I hope all this background answers the question, why do we need ATM?